out to Waltham, and I believe it's kind of the fifth version of the Matisho Memorial. I've kind of lost track. Maybe if I realized it was really important that I kept track, but I think we're on about number five now. For those of you who didn't know Larry, I thought I would just share a little bit about him, because we really, this event kind of got started, and Larry was a big, big part of this event. And the way it kind of started was a number of years ago, and I'm here by accident. That's how that happened too. Marcel Farmelo phones me one day, and we're talking about inlay, and all of a sudden at the end of the call he says, "Oh, by the way, signed you up for an advanced turning class. Bring $50 to the next guild meeting," and then hung up. So I would not describe my turning skills as advanced. And when we met, Trent was teaching the class, and when we met at the next guild meeting, I made sure I quickly assured him that I was no expert turner. And he assured me that didn't matter. And Larry was the host of the event. So we met for a number of years. I forget how many. In Larry's shop in Saskatoon. And when I look around the group here today, there were a number of people here that were at that very first one. And we were all just kind of getting started, and all the rest of you now are really good turners. So that's kind of where this came about. And then we were in the middle of planning the next year. I would always harass Larry about this because I had so much fun that I would always go, "Well, what are we doing next year? What are we doing next year?" You know, and we were in the middle, we're just talking about the next year, and all of a sudden Larry passed away very suddenly from cancer, and we were kind of a group of us, I think it was Mel and Trent and myself, one day at a guild meeting we were talking, and we needed space. Well, our school division has been really good with space. In fact, Mel kept reminding me that I should really ask before I spoke. I just said, "Yeah, we can do it here." I didn't seem to be good enough, but yeah, I did ask eventually. And then Trent basically stated, "Well, you know, why don't we, instead of paying $50 for the class," that's where that $50 came from, we used to pay that to attend the class, "why don't we just bring a check made out to the Canadian Cancer Society?" And you know, that little discussion basically has led to this. So. I thought that since we're kind of turning in memory of Larry, I know there's lots of you that knew Larry better than I did, but I got to know Larry through the guild, and to say Larry was excited about turning was an understatement. Every guild meeting, once I got to know him, he would come to me and kind of in a wide-eyed Larry fashion be explaining the latest jig or the latest tool that he had played with, and he put DC motor on his old Rockwell lathe, and he was playing with that. There are always kind of neat things that he was doing, and when you went into his house, it took a little while to sink in, but as you scanned the walls, there were a lot of turnings in that one, in his rec room especially. So, you know, and this kind of unfolded, I thought, well, what a better person to name this kind of event after than somebody like Larry, who is such a neat guy and so adamant about turning. I still, one incident with Larry, I don't know if I should say it, but I'm going to name it. Larry was turning, I think, the first or the second one, a very, very long hollow vessel, glued together, padauk, all kinds of woods glued together. And he's turning away, and the guys usually gave me a little bit of grief at these events because I'd often wear safety glasses and a face shield because that's what my students wear, and I'm just kind of used to it. So Larry figures, "Oh, I should try a face shield, see what that's like." So I just happened to take a break from my lathe, and I'm standing beside Larry, just right at the end of his lathe, and he's got that big, long piece on that Rockwell just howling. And all of a sudden, the tool catches, and that blank just explodes, and a big chunk of it right dead between the eyes on the face shield. And And I just happened to be looking around, and the strangest thing, I will never forget this, I actually saw his pupils dilating as that thing hit him right between the eyes. And the odd thing is, he cleaned up his lathe and took off his face shield and never wore it again. turning with Larry was a real treat. And for those of you that didn't get to know him, I'm sure that you know of people like that, and especially with when we're raising money to handle a very, very serious disease. We all know somebody who's maybe passed away from cancer, or maybe has it now and is dealing with it. And it seems like it's depressing. It seems like every year about this time in our community here, there's something that comes up. And right now, our vice principal's 16-year-old daughter is, they heard the L word last week, leukemia, and they're hopefully ruling it out. But it's important that we do this work, and hopefully we can get other clubs to do this. And so we're gonna, tomorrow when we can talk about some of the measures that, I think I spend too much time at my computer because I think of these things. So this time I'll run them by you before I just do them. But so basically that's why we're doing it. And so maybe, if you're turning this afternoon, spend a minute or two thinking of Larry or thinking of somebody that you know that's dealing with cancer, has dealt with it, or even the extended family. Cancer doesn't just affect one person. It's the whole family unit that's affected. So take a minute during the day to think about that. The hope is that everybody here just has a good time, and we're really hoping that for those of you that have been here for many years, we're certainly hoping that you'll continue to attend, and those of you that are new, also hoping that you'll mark this weekend off on your calendar and show up every year. We'd sure appreciate that. Okay, well, thank you very much.